Good afternoon, my dear student. Yesterday I discussed in front of you all, my dear student, about these physical features of North America, and today I am going to talk about South America. Okay, its physical features. Mostly yesterday also I recited in front of you all that I explained the physical features of North America, I explained the physical features of South America. Or explain the physical features of Africa. Like this, there is many times the question has been asked in the examination. So that today our topic is that the physical features, okay, the land topography of this South America, okay. It occupies about 12% of this world area, okay. Just you have to remember that the 12% of this world area that has been covered by this South America. And similarly, the land, it is also famous by the land of extreme, okay? It is also famous by the name, the land of what is extreme. And it lies between 12 degree north, okay? 55 degree south in its latitude. This is this location, about 12 degree north to 55 degree south latitude. And in this northwest and in the northern side, there lies about this Caribbean Sea. Mostly in the examination, in the world map, the Caribbean Sea has been already asked in the examination. So, Caribbean Sea lies in the northwest and this northern part of this South America. Similarly, there lies this Atlantic Ocean. Okay, my dear student? Of course, yes, there is no doubt. This Atlantic Ocean lies in this northeast as well as east and the southeast part, that is this Atlantic Ocean. And similarly, Pacific Ocean lies in this western side. These are the information about this location about this South America, and it is also formed by these three land features. Okay, now the first one is that the Andes Mountain, and second one is the Central Lowland, and this third one is this Eastern Highland. By the combination of these three, the topography or you can say physical features, the South America has made. Now let's discuss about this Andes Mountain, my dear student. Okay, how much you must have to understand and how much you have to create the answer in the examination. Create this answer in this examination, just follow me, my dear student. Okay, the Andes Mountain is the second highest fold mountain that is formed 10 to 15 million years ago. It is formed in 10 or 15 million years ago, and they are this longest chain. Okay. Of this unbroken mountain in this world is extended from, actually it is extended means that is Andes Mountain extended from Venezuela to Tierra del Fuego. Okay, it is extended from Venezuela to Tierra del Fuego, and there are 7000 kilometer, it is extended 7000 kilometer almost in this parallel shape. Okay, in parallel shape, it has been extended from Venezuela to Tierra del Fuego, and Atacama Desert also lies here. Just remember, these things should be you have to write in the examination in the physical features of South America in this Andes Mountain. The Atacama Desert also lies here, and Mount Aconcagua, its height is 6,960 meter in height. It is also important for this map. It is already asked in this examination, given in the 10th set also as well as the 30 days practice. So there is no doubt, my dear student. And Lake Titicaca also lies in this Andes Mountain area. But this much you must have to create the answer in the physical features of North America in the first, that is the Andes Mountain. Okay, my dear student? Yes. Now, second one is that Central Lowland. Okay, it lies in the central part of the South America, and it is extended, yes, from this Andes in the west to Eastern Highland in this east. Okay, the Central Lowland extended from the Andes in the west to the east, Eastern Highland to this east, and similarly, the Central Lowland is drained by many rivers like this River Orinoco, similarly River Amazon, similarly River La, Plata river system. Okay, by the combinations of this river and the drain of this river, like the Orinoco, Amazon, as well as the La, Plata, these rivers also lie in the Central Lowland of the South America. And this region is covered by the tropical grassland. Yes, it is also important. This region means that a central lowland is covered by this tropical, yes, grassland. They are known as the llanos. And they are also known as the pampas. Especially pampa is mostly found in the Argentina. So there are questions is asked in the examination that why Argentina export this meat. Huge amount of the meat all over the world in these regions. Like this, these questions are asked in examination. Okay, my dear student, later on I will discuss you. Just listen me right now. The Amazon basin is the largest river that also lies here in this world that is covered by this evergreen forest. That forest is known as the selvas, where trees are 50 meter tall in this height. Okay, 90% of the living creatures are found in this evergreen forest in the Amazon basin. But it is not known as the zoo of the world because many poisonous creatures and these animals are found there in the Amazon. So there are this tropical evergreen forest that is found in the Amazon basin. Basin means that the side of these rivers, the substance of this vegetation or the forest is obviously known as, my dear student, the selvas. Okay. So by the combination of all these things, the central lowland has been formed about this South America. Okay. And similarly, the eastern highland is formed by these two. Yes, highland especially. The first one is Guyana Highland. Okay, we are now talking about this last topography, okay, so last is geography about the South America. The eastern highland is formed by these two highlands. One is that by the Guyana Highland. That Guyana Highland lies in this north, and similarly, next one is this Brazilian Highland that lies in this northeast. Okay. And mount is Pico, yes, Pico da Bandeira. Pico da Bandeira also lies here. Its height is about this 2,890 meter in height. It is the highest mountain peak that lies in this Brazil. And the longest is waterfall. Everybody know that this longest waterfall in the world, that is the Angel Fall, also lies in this eastern highlands, and it falls from this 979 meter in height. That is, yes, flow from this up, yes, down, lies in this Guyana Highland in this Venezuela. By the combination of the yes Andes Mountain, by the combination of the central lowland, as well as the by the combination of the eastern highland, yes, my dear student, the yes South America has been yes formed, and it lies between yes 12 degree to yes 55 yes degree in the south, yes, latitude, and it occupies about this 12% of the world land area. Okay, my dear students. Similarly, it is the land of this extreme. Now listen to me here. One question I brought you for my dear student. Argentina export this large amount of the meat in this all over the world. Why give the reason? This is very interesting question. And substance of the questions are given in this textbook also in the list, you can see here. And similarly, it is also given in the 10 set as well as this 30 days practice. Okay, now listen to me here. Argentina export the meat in the huge amount in the world, in all over the world. Okay, विश्व भरिमा सबभन्दा बढी मासु बेच्ने देश भनेर चाहिँ अर्जेन्टिनालाई मानिन्छ, चिनिन्छ, बुझिन्छ. Why? Give the reasons. Like this, my dear student, the questions are actually examination. The first one is that already I explained that temperate grassland, that is pampas, are found in this Argentina, so that it is very suitable to this real these animals. Okay, that is the first reason that Argentina exports this meat in all over the world in huge amount. Okay, the first one is that most part of the land of Argentina is covered by this temperate grassland that is known as this pampa. First reason. Now second one is that animals are slaughtered. Many more slaughter companies are constructed. Slaughter means badsala. Animals are like that. Machines are very cutting. Machines are very cutting. They are processing, packing, load, and export in all over the world. Substantial facilities are highly developed. Many more slaughter companies are formed in this near the seaport, so that modern refrigerators are used. Chemicals are used for this processing about this raw meat, and they are packed and they are exported to this abroad nation. That is also the reasons behind that Argentina export this meat in all over the world. That is the second reasons. Okay, and third one is that the climate as well as the weather phenomena is also very suitable for the rearing about this animals as well as these cattle. And most of the people of the Argentina, they involved, they are engaged, okay, in this animal rearing as a commercial purpose, okay, and commercial purpose. So these are the reasons, my dear student, that Argentina export the meat in the huge amount in all over the world. Okay, my dear student, this much for today. Again, tomorrow I will talk on this next topic. Thank you very much.